This is a demonstration of the power flow through a General Motors Hydra-Matic 6T70 transaxle. This is a six-speed transaxle that has been used since 2007 in front-wheel drive GM passenger cars, typically with small V8s or larger V6 engines. There's a 6T75 version of this that's been beefed up a little bit more to handle higher input torque, and there's a 6T40 and a 6T45 for smaller four-cylinder engines that is patterned after the same transaxle. This transaxle, being a six-speed, has three planetary gear sets. We have an input gear set, a reaction gear set, and an output gear set that are in this, inside of all of this, with your standard planetary sun gear, planet carrier with planet gears, and ring gears. We have three separate sun gears, three separate planet carriers, and three separate ring gears on this transmission, so we don't have a Simpson gear set or any other type of gear set here. It's just three simple planetary gear sets in line with each other. There are several clutch packs in this transaxle to be aware of. We have a 4-5-6 clutch pack that is going to spline to this housing that connects to the reaction carrier. We have a 3-5 clutch pack that's inside of this housing that will rotate with the turbine shaft, the input shaft that's hooked to the torque converter. And then we also have a 2-6 clutch that splines to the outside of the same housing that will stop it from rotating in second and sixth gears. We have a low and reverse clutch that will grab these teeth. That low and reverse clutch is also used in conjunction with this one-way roller clutch, or one-way clutch. It's not a roller clutch and it's not a sprag. If you listen carefully, it's actually got a ratchet mechanism to lock it in the one direction, very much like a ratchet of a tool set. And then we have a 1-2-3-4 clutch pack that'll be down here. And by the way, the 2-6 clutch, the low and reverse clutch, and the 1-2-3-4 clutches, these are all holding clutches. They're going to grab these housings and stop them from rotating in the gears that their name represents. And then down here we have the output foot to the final drive. There's an idler gear and then the final drive gear in this transaxle. And then we have an input shaft that goes into the torque converter, into the turbine, and this shaft goes all the way down through the center of all of these three planetary gears, and it actually splines to one of those inside with this set of splines right here. I think it's the reaction sun gear, if I remember correctly. So when our engine turns, the torque converter is going to turn this housing down, or the turbine shaft down below. Well, that's the same as turning this upper housing here, because they're connected together. So what I'd like to do is run you through the six forward gears and reverse on this transaxle. So to get started with, we will do reverse. For reverse, we're going to have the 3-5 reverse clutch come on, and this is inside of this housing, so it's going to turn. And then we're going to have the lower reverse clutch come on, and it will hold this piece from turning. And we've got a reverse gear ratio of 2.880:1. So if I hold this solid and we watch this sticker here, I should turn this 3-5 reverse clutch housing 2.88 times to get one full turn of this output gear. So here we go, and notice it's turning backwards of the direction I'm turning the 3-5 reverse clutch. There's one, two, and not quite three. 2.880 turns of the input to one turn of the output. All right, now let's go to first gear. In first gear, we're going to have the 1, 2, 3, 4 clutch apply, which is going to hold this housings steady. And then we're also in first gear just going to turn the input shaft that's splined to the reaction sun gear. So first gear is very low on this transmission. It's actually a 4.484 to 1 gear ratio, extremely low gear ratio. So if we watch the input turning here to the output turning, whoops, I got to hold the low and reverse clutch also. So here we go. One turn, two turns of the input, three turns of the input, four turns of the input, and there we are, 4.484, so 4.5 turns of the input to get one turn of our output. So that's first gear. Second gear, we're going to continue to hold the 1, 2, 3, 4 clutch, and now we're going to turn, now we're going to hold also the 2-6 clutch. So I'm going to hold both of these, this housing, and turn the input, and our second gear ratio is 2.872 to 1. So I'm going to hold both of those the best I can and turn the input. Let me get the sticker lined up here. Okay, so here we go. One input turn, two input turns, and not quite three, 2.872 input turns to one turn of the output for second gear. For third gear, we'll continue to hold the 1, 2, 3, 4 clutch housing from turning, and now we'll apply the 3-5 reverse clutch, which is inside of this housing. So that means we're going to hold this housing, we're going to turn this housing the same speed as our input shaft, and we should get 1.842 turns of the input to one turn of the output. So here we go. There's one turn in, and about 0.8 of a turn around, 1.8 to 1 gear ratio for third gear. Fourth gear is a gear ratio of 1.41 to 1, and so now we're going to have the 4-5-6 clutch apply. The 4-5-6 clutch, if you recall, is down inside of this housing, and it's going to spline to our input housing. So I'm going to simulate that by putting that down in there and wedging it in place with a paper towel, just for this demonstration. We'll put that whole assembly back in here, lined up. So we're looking at fourth gear with a gear ratio of 1.4 turns of the input to one turn of the output. So we're going to hold the 1, 2, 3, 4 for fourth gear clutch and turn the 4-5-6 clutch housing with the input and get 1.4 turns. So here's one turn of the input, and we've got one turn of the output to 1.4 turns of the input. Now fifth gear on this transaxle is direct drive, and so we're going to have the 4-5-6 clutch apply, which is inside of this housing. We just had that apart. We're also going to have the 3-5 reverse clutch apply. So that means both of these are going to turn the same speed. They're locked together. So I'm just simply going to hold these two together and turn it. And one turn in equals one turn out, which is our fifth gear direct drive on this transaxle. So this transaxle is not a double overdrive, it's a single overdrive, and only in sixth gear. In sixth gear, we've got a gear ratio of 0.742 to 1, so we're going to still drive the 4-5-6 clutch down inside of this housing, but now we are going to hold the 2.6 clutch housing right here steady. So let me get this back around so we can see our sticker here. And so I'm going to hold this solid, turn the 4.56 clutch, and we should get one full turn of the output to the final drive with only roughly 3/4 of a turn of the input. So here we go. Notice it's turned, the output is turning faster than the input. There's one full turn in, and we did not get one full turn out. We started right over here. So that's the 0.742:1 gear ratio in sixth gear. So once again, this has been a demonstration of the power flow through a Hydra-Matic, which is General Motors, 6T70 front-wheel drive transaxle used in 2007 and above General Motors, or select General Motors front-wheel drive passenger cars.